In part 14, I started to develop my new custom hand loads for the 2011 season. I also discussed some of the differences between digital and beam type powder scales. With the preliminary testing phase out of the way, it was time to put my new digital scale to work. The biggest advantage to having an electronic scale is speed. Weighing static items only takes a couple of seconds. So a monotonous task, like weight sorting 100 brand new cases, can easily be accomplished in a short amount of time. Weight sorting our brass has the potential to increase precision. If two pieces of brass have the same weight and external dimensions, then theoretically the internal dimensions should be the same. Therefore, when the shots are fired, the pressure created should be close enough that we get a similar muzzle velocity. Of course, this theory may not apply to a factory rifle such as mine. Once I had finished sorting all the cases, I divided them into groups of 10. I then numbered each case to help keep them organized. With the cases taken care of, I decided to try something that most people will view as a complete waste of time. But it was cold outside and I was bored, so I decided to weight sort my bullets as well. Now, there's nothing really out there that implies that weight sorting bullets can improve precision. This was basically just another test of the digital scale to find out how much it drifts during extended use.
So I've been sitting here using this new Gempro 250 to measure out my bullets. So far I'd have to say that this thing does not drift like I was worried about. Really don't ever have to calibrate it. I continually am checking the calibration just to see what it says, but so far whenever I throw that calibration weight on there, it gives me the exact same number. As you can see, I was a little bit worried about domino effect. The whole point of this is I want to get a nice image of the bell curve this is going to provide after I've got all 500 rounds sorted out.
The extreme low was 174.82 grains. With the bulk of the rounds ending up at 175.1 grains, and the extreme high being 175.52 grains. It only took me about 2 hours to create this setup. And as you can see, weight sorting the bullets created a pretty standard bell curve distribution. Remember that varmint load I had started developing? Well, I had given the bullets and brass for that load the same treatment. So I now have all of my brass and all of my bullets for the 2011 season sorted by weight class. Again, there's no proof that being this anal retentive will actually improve my precision, but I can always hope. You've now seen the general improvements I've made to both the rifle and the ammunition. So it's time to go back to the range and continue load development. The first group I shot with the varmint bullets was nice, however, it didn't really give me a good starting point. So I decided to take a closer look at the muzzle velocities. Even though the velocities were increasing as the powder charge went up, there are two areas where the velocity was not really affected by the increase in powder charge. So I decided to test each of these loads with a 5-shot group. Unfortunately, I screwed up the first shot of my day, sending it way outside of the group. The first three groups were the best of the day. I was annoyed that I had screwed up the first group because the muzzle velocities were extremely tight. 45.7 grains was definitely showing the most potential. So I went back to the range for one more day of testing.
So we got a 20 mile an hour wind out here.
The wind was gusting from 15 to 20 miles per hour. To shoot a nice group in these conditions was going to take some extra effort. There was a tall blade of grass that was visible through my scope. I decided to use it as my wind gauge and would only shoot when the blade of grass was tilted full over to the left. I messed up on shot number 4, but I have no idea what happened to shot number 5. Considering the gusting wind, I was very impressed with group number 2. This final day of testing identified that 45.7 grains was definitely the sweet spot. Even when we ignore the effects of wind and only look at the vertical component, you can see that groups 1 and 3 had a similar vertical dispersion, while group number 2 was tight in both the vertical and horizontal elements. My varmint round was now complete, but there was one more test I wanted to do with this ammo before I started mass producing it. I wanted to find out if my new electronic scale was making any difference. To do this, I devised a test that would put the old system against the new system. I built up 10 rounds using each system. The first 10 rounds would simulate the reloading processes I used a year ago before I got the new electronic scale. I used a somewhat random selection of bullets and cases to create each round. I then weighed out 45.7 grains of powder with the beam type scale. The next 10 rounds would represent my new reloading methods. I found 10 bullets that were all 109.98 grains. I also used cases that were from the same weight class. And lastly, all the powder charges were weighed to within 2/100ths of a grain. With my 20 rounds loaded up, I was off to the range. The first two groups had me pretty convinced that the Gempro 250 was making a big difference. After letting the barrel cool down, I shot the next two groups and reversed the order. With all the bullets on paper, the results were obvious. The Gempro 250 was definitely increasing my level of precision.